Hello children, today let's learn how to go about the bit rewrite as director in paper 2 section B grammar and vocabulary. On to the passage here. Remember children, go through the passage twice or thrice before answering the questions. Read the following passage focusing on the parts that are underlined and numbered. On to the passage. Oliver was frightened at the sight of so many gentlemen. "What is your name, boy?" said the gentleman in the high chair. "Boy, listen to me. You know you are an orphan, I suppose," said the gentleman. "What's that, sir?" inquired poor Oliver. Mr. Bumble caned Oliver. Look, children, the first sentence underlined is in connection with the first question. Second sentence, or the number 2, and the sentence following is underlined, that is with regard to question number 2. And number 3 and the following sentence, which is underlined, is in connection with the question number 3. Now complete the following sentences and write them as directed in your answer booklet. Remember children, never write the passage in your answer script. You can write the half of the sentence in one color and rest of it in another color, or you can just underline the answer that you have done or what you have written in order to complete the sentence. Here we go with the first question. The gentleman in the high chair asked. Look children, the first sentence from the passage is, "What is your name, boy?" said the gentleman in the high chair. And here the half of the sentence is, "The gentleman in the high chair asked." With this we understand that it is a conversion of direct speech to indirect speech. And we all know that when we convert a sentence from direct to indirect speech, we need to see what type of sentence is there in between the inverted commas. So if we look at the sentence, "What is your name, boy?" That is a WH question, for which we do not need to use any linking word. So here goes the answer this way. The gentleman in the high chair asked what his name was. So you shouldn't write what was his name, because in the question format it is verb plus subject. Whereas when you change it into a statement, you need to make it subject plus verb. His name is a subject, was is the verb. And you all know the conversion of tense. Is changes to was, that is present to past. On to the second question. You know you are an orphan. And there is a blank given at the end of the sentence. This indicates that we need to add a question tag. So we need to look at the verb here. Look children, do not get confused with the R in the sentence. You know you are an orphan. Here R is not the verb. Here the verb is know. You are an orphan is the noun phrase or noun clause, you can say, which can be substituted with it. Hence, you need to recognize the verb. Here, the verb is know. Know is nothing but do plus know. So, the question tag you all know. If the sentence is positive, we have a negative question tag. And if the sentence is negative, we have a positive question tag. Since the sentence here is positive, we add a negative question tag, that is, don't you? On to the next sentence, Mr. Bumble caned Oliver. And here Oliver was. That means we need to change it from active voice to passive voice, where the subject goes to object place and object goes to subject place. So here goes the way. Mr. Bumble caned. This is in past tense. So Oliver was caned by Mr. Bumble. So I have already made videos for direct and indirect speech, question tags, active and passive voice. Refer those videos. You will get an idea how to go about with the rewrite as directed. Each question carries 1 mark, which is very simple and easy to attempt. So do not miss this or skip this part. Try to go through those videos. Hope you would all do that. And children, do comment in the comment box below. And subscribe for further updates on rewrite as directed. If you give a like, I'll be very happy for that. Thank you, children. Thank you and have a blessed day.